I try to make some music these days. I try.
What guitars were used on the first album?
There was a some kind of a Jubilee model of Jackson back then.
So what was it that inspired you guys to alter your guitar sound? Because it's kind of obvious from Soul Side Journey, by the time you got the Blaze in the Northern Sky,
yeah,
sounds like the treble just went wham! And it's just pretty much a whole new approach, man. What inspired that?
When we started out like, you know, more like we sound now, actually.
Mm-hmm.
When you're 15, 16 years old, you really want to be good at the instrument. And so it went to even more technical stuff. And, you know, the Goldlord album is like, it's actually a rehearsal tape.
Yeah,
but
a trip on that one.
That was the actual follow-up to Soul Side Journey.
Right, and then you guys didn't release it.
No, yeah, exactly.
You released Blaze in the Northern Sky.
Yeah, because the music we were listening to all the time was of course, other stuff like the 70s music and early 80s, you know, black metal and metal stuff, and thrash metal from... And so we wonder why are we bothering playing all this? You know, it's very chaotic, and why don't we play some more straightforward things?
Back to basics.
Yeah, really. Yeah. So
definitely strip it down.
Yeah, don't have anything to prove anymore.
No, exactly, because after Goldlord, it's like, what are we gonna do? How are we going to top this one?
It's punk as fuck that you guys shelved that,
yeah.
And then you told your label dudes like, check this out.
Mm.
Here's a Blaze in the Northern Sky,
yeah.
And then little did they know that was going to become a fucking cult classic.
Yeah, I mean, I remember because Peaceville at the time, they thought we were joking. They got the master tapes and they wanted us to record it again or at least remix it or something. And we said, no, this is it, you know, this is shit. So, and the year after, we were the best-selling band on the label. So
that's what happens when you stick to your guns, man. That shows when that album was out. Or did you already stop by then?
I mean, we did actually play one show in Denmark in 91, and I think we was doing three shows in Finland.
Yeah.
But otherwise, we didn't do anything because, of course, the label wants us to go touring, and they said, you will sell more album when you're touring. But we denied that.
It's kind of cool, then it's like, if you're really interested, go and find it.
Mm-hmm.
If you might have heard it through word of mouth, you go, well, I got mine, you know, I can make you a copy or you can go find it,
mm-hmm.
Which is kind of like, you know, doing it yourself, man.
But it was before the internet, and probably people didn't have cars and a license,
right.
And you don't get around so easily.
It was all about zines. I'll mail you a letter.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Yeah,
who's gonna do that when you're drunk and high and fucking blasted all the time? It's hard to get.
Well, we did do a lot of responding to mail. So we sat down and wrote letters. Hello, thanks. You know, and we exchanged flyers and demos maybe, and
that,
we tried to. You know.
That goes a long way. That's what I do. I make custom boards in my garage.
Oh yeah.
And I've been doing it for quite some time now.
Yeah, I saw some pretty impressive pictures of you skating
I'm done, I can quit. That's my retirement right there, quote. Put out the retirement board. How does it feel having that much of an effect on a lot of skateboarders around the world, and especially America?
It inspired so many grinds.
I didn't know it could happen,
mm.
But it does feel definitely nice.
Yeah.
It's, you know, because some years after you think, well, yeah, people actually like our music, you know, that's good, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Or, I mean, without music, you know, the world wouldn't be like this at all.
Yeah, it'd be a lot lamer.
Yeah, a lot lamer.
Yeah,
tons lame.
Cheers to that.
That's good.
Did you make a conscious effort, like, okay, I played this way on Soul Side,
mm.
On Blaze, I want to play this way?
Of course, it was an effort because it all, so all of a sudden it was all fresh for us as well, and we took what you know, the essence of what we believed was cold and like dark music, you know, and we were really fucking satisfied with it.
Talked about the new guitar, custom icon, for Nocturno Culto. Explain your sound on the last three albums, why that's so much different.
Obviously, we bought the right equipment, and this is like freedom when you have your own studio. You can control everything yourself, and this new kind of freedom led us like almost back to do when we started, because music was then suddenly extremely more fun, you know, like we have to change because we find music is refreshing, you know.
Had that in my head. It's like you almost kind of gotta twist it and go back in time, because now it's like bands just keep going more extreme. There's kids playing 7-string guitars. You know, dum 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 dum, and you know the forefathers, like yourselves, kind of went back in time and played music like you have been listening to.
Yeah, we probably like to challenge our own fans as well as ourselves.
Right.
Yeah. But to quote Lemmy, you know, you gain some, you lose some. It's all the same to that.
Wow. Nicely played.
Words. Excellent.
He's the man.
Yeah. Lemmy just had an interview in Thrasher, the editor of Thrasher, Jake Phelps.
Oh yeah,
that was good.
Did an interview with Lemmy, that was really good.
Yeah, it was funny, they were kind of just bouncing off each other.
Yeah, I want to see that.
Old man of skateboarding interviewing old man of rock.
Yeah, it sounded like they were about to go out and party after that.
Probably we talked to Thrasher Mag. I think Thrasher Mag is a kind of huge mag in America, at least so I heard. Yeah. Also like, are you fucking kidding me? The thing that skating and rock and metal has in common is that, you know, it's probably about the freedom and doing what the fuck you want to do, you know?
Yeah, so, believe it.
Yeah.
Definitely, I agree 100%, yeah. What, if anything, you've been listening to lately that might be obscure, that we wouldn't think you'd be listening to?
Yeah, I'm going to show you the line.
Voivod, like it.
Yeah, Voivod.
Metal Church.
Okay.
Have you heard it?
Awesome. Trying to figure out where the Titan Blood album is.
Vaklevoren, oh yeah.
Vaklevoren.
Wobbly. Repulsion.
It's one of my absolutely faves.
Epic.
Yes.
Ooh.
This is death metal.
Yeah.
They made some kind of a booklet which more reminds you of an underground fan song.
Yeah. This is the way to do it.
See, that hands-on stuff is, I think, what we're missing in music, man. You can download your album, you can buy it off iTunes, but you don't get to hold it in your hands.
Because people are starting to realize that the vinyl is like more of a product, really.
Mm-hmm.
Because you have to take care of it.
Yeah, sure.
And of course it sounds better if you have that.
As a musician, explain how important it is to maybe be recluse.
You know, personally, I've always been hiding away. I don't get inspired by going to a show, going to, you know, like a festival area with lots of people and stuff. It's so I like to be by myself. I'm just a guy making riffs, you know, I've been doing that as a hobby for all these years. It's good, you know. I mean, people pick their inspirations from probably various things. I don't know why, it's probably very individual. But to me, I think silence is one of them. Because then I can hear things that I usually don't hear.
In the earlier Dark Throne albums, it seems like the message was like promoting a rebellion against Christianity. Mm-hmm. If there's a message, if any, coming out of the new albums, what might it be?
You know, we're trying to disguise some of our opinions in lyrics, you know, in good lyrics.
What do you guys got in the works?
We recorded two songs March last year. We were thinking about calling the new album The Underground Resistance.
Nice.
But we're not sure yet.
So we should be ready to sniff out a new Dark Throne album sometime, whenever the fuck you guys want to release it.
Yeah, something like that, yeah. Hopefully next year, I hope. So, we'll see, you know.
Excellent.
Thank you.